I'd like to show you how to remove all epsilon productions or empty productions from a grammar in order to create a Chomsky normal form or to do bottom-up parsing. And removing means that we want to have a grammar that produces the same words, so we don't want to change in that, but maybe the derivations change. And in this case, we have epsilon production. So we have a non-terminal that goes to epsilon, but it doesn't go to anything else. So let's have a look at this case. If you do a derivation, I give you an example. If you start with the starting symbol, then you replace it by the right-hand side. And now if you replace the A by an epsilon, so by the empty word, what you get is something like this, so the A just falls out. So, and when we remove the epsilon productions, what we do, we can just skip this, step and say that, that S in one step derives to BAB. So in order to remove the A in this position, so we don't, so we will not need the rule here anymore, we can just cross the A out and make that the S derives to BAB. So now we have another rule that says B goes to A. And let me show you the derivation of it. If you say we have a if we maybe have a B, and then we replace it by an A, and then we will just replace it by epsilon, so by nothing. And here we can do the same thing, we just skip the step and say that B derives in one step to epsilon. So we just take the A out and replace it by epsilon, or to say it, to replace it by nothing. So now we don't have the A in any right-hand rule, so we don't need the A rule anymore. But now we have another epsilon production, which is B goes to epsilon, and the B is near in the right-hand side, as you can see here. And now we have to do the same step again. Now we still have can do the derivation S goes to B. And then the B is replaced by epsilon. And now we just want to skip the step and replace it by S derives to epsilon. So we just take the B here out and replace it by epsilon. Now we don't have a B in any right-hand side of any rule, so we don't need this rule again. And now you see that there's still one epsilon rule, S goes to epsilon. But in an epsilon free, in a grammar without epsilon productions, this is the only rule that is allowed. Because at the beginning of a parsing, you can easily check if the word is empty or not. And if it's empty, you would just say it's in the language because of this rule. And in every other case, you don't need this rule again. But those rule is only allowed if the S doesn't appear in any right-hand side of a rule. So this is the only rule that is allowed in a grammar without epsilon productions. And because we don't have any other epsilon productions, we are done.